Well, whoa, sorry about that. Kind of fell over there for a bit. There we go. Camera problems. Well, I've already gotten the day started. I'm supposed to be walking to do food shopping, but it seems to be raining out quite a bit, so I don't know if I'm gonna go or not. Sorry about that. I don't know if I'm gonna go or not. We'll sort of have to see what happens with the weather. Anyways, let's give you a time and date stamp. It is 18 hours and 52 minutes into the day of June 25th, 2014. And so, supposed to go food shopping, but I don't know if it's going to work out because it is raining pretty heavily. I might take the chance and walk in the rain. I don't know. I haven't made that decision yet. it's not that cold out, so I might actually do that. It doesn't call for a thunder shower, so it's not lightning out at all. So it's not that bad to walk. It just might be a little wet, that's all. So as long as I don't mind being wet a little bit, then we'll be kind of okay. And, you know, it's kind of how things go sometimes. Yeah, so that's about it for now. I'm trying to get things back in order again. I am uploading another video, so our upload schedule should come back to its normal self. I'm cutting down the number of uploads for BTS Vlog because more odd stuff is coming online. And what's happening is that you'll get two BTS Vlogs a week, basically. Or three, depending if we're behind, we're gonna get three BTS vlogs a week. If we're behind, if we're not behind, then it's normally just gonna be two. So that's how I decided to work things out. So yeah, Cyborg Alpha TV Network is now operational. We're not working. It's now a matter of putting the content out there. So anyway. I will see you maybe in a bit. I'll let you know probably about a half hour what I'm going to do in terms of walking. We'll kind of have to sort of play that by ear. Anyways, take it easy. Well, if you guys are wondering what's going on and why things have been kind of screwy lately, getting into the summer, we just get things, we just get the channel started in terms of the Cyborg Alpha TV Network, and things kind of fall off. Well, this is what happens when you're between projects, when one project is ending and another project is beginning, and these are primarily sub-projects. The project that you're finishing requires cleaning up, and the project you're starting requires organization and configuration. And that's kind of where we are. So, Let me give you the time and date stamp. It is 3 hours and 45 minutes into the day of June, of Friday, of 3 hours and 3 hours and 47 minutes into the day of Friday, June 27th, 2014. Yeah. I'm coming to the close of June. I've been working on my TV here, the IPTV. Things have more or less been stabilized. I realized that I had to take off Google Hangout. Not only Google, I had to take out Google Hangouts a long time ago. That was causing problems. So now I also then decided just about 2 weeks ago to remove Google Plus, and because I was having problems with the stability, and I looked at all the different options and tried to sort of whittle what was causing the problem, realized it was Google Plus, took off Google Plus, and all the problems that I was having disappeared. So Google Plus is now gone from IPTV. The way I deal with Google Plus is I have all Google Plus on Cyborg Alpha Mu, and that's how I deal with it. As for what's going on is, I'm finishing one segment of a research project. As I said, I break up research projects into sub-projects, and when one sub-project finishes, another one begins, and that's kind of where we are up now. Is I'm finishing one project, one sub-project. I've got organized the notes and the results from that, and I'm beginning another sub-project this week as well. So basically what ends up happening, this is what's going to cause the hiatus from July 15th, from mid-July to mid-August, for just about 1 month, and there's going to be a hiatus in filming and even uploading. What happens is that the research gets too much. There's too much work to get done, to do both at the same time, and I need that sort of that break and film. Not filming, because I am going to be filming the vlog. I'm still going to vlog through everything. I'm just not really going to be uploading. And what will happen is when I come back, then I'll start uploading again, and there'll be a whole queue of stuff to handle. See, what happens when you upload, you have to send out the announcement that it's out there. You have to interact with the people who ask questions. There's a lot of things that have to go on that sort of put you in a situation where it's difficult to get all the work done. And this is kind of where I decided, well, let's give myself a bit of a break. I might not even be here for a large chunk of the time. I might have to go. This is what I usually do on between that period. I usually go out and do some research. I do some wilderness research. And if I'm out doing that type of research, I'm not around enough. To do the editing, sorry about that, to do the editing and keep a proper upload schedule. So that's how that's going to end up working out. By the way, I had a pretty good day today. My legs are still a little bit sore from walking yesterday. And I should be finishing up in about 15-20 minutes. And that means I'll be getting to bed around 4 o'clock in the morning and just sleeping most of the day. All right, I'll talk to you guys later. Let you know what's happening. I do have more IMO, another IMO vlog to do sometime later today, but I'm still working on the notes for that, and we'll see when I get to it. All right, take it easy. Good morning, everybody. Yeah, summer's definitely here, and it is getting hotter. So it means that I will have to break down and turn on the AC, and so I'm gonna get ready to do that today. Let's see here. It's even though I said good morning, it's not necessarily morning, and it is 17 hours into the day of Friday, June 27th, 2014. And it's time to start another day. So that's what we're going to do. We have a lot on schedule for today. Let's see what I can get done. I have work on the editing bay. I have to clear up some of that backlog and get things moving again. I have more filming scheduled for today. Primarily, the Insta vlog. We have, I think, two things to do on Insta vlogs today. Those should be going up. They're rather easy to do and to then eventually edit. So, Not much of an issue there. The ones that are issued, the ones that's an issue are still the larger shows like Beauty and the Geek, where that have a lot of overlay graphics and the interactive graphics in it. And that's where it really bogged down, is on the interactive graphics. I don't know, it does seem to present a bit of a problem. I'm going to try to work that out today, but we'll see what happens. Anyways, as I do different things, if something's of interest, I will let you know. I will vlog it, and yeah. Anyways, see you around today. All right, take it easy.
Exciting news! Yeah, just a few hours ago, earlier today, I was doing the work. I think it was between. It must have been around 8 o'clock. I had finished taking some of my notes. I mean, this is what happens when projects finish, and these are sub-projects. You have to clear up your notes, you have to organize things, and then from these notes, you determine which direction you're going to move into next. So I had finished up actually several sub-projects in a row. There were a couple sub-projects that I had finished. And when I sat down to look at what sub-project had finished, I realized that the next step would be to start moving into Project Tesla. And that's what's going on now. Project Tesla, which has been scheduled for October 2014, has started today. I've already did my first day of research on Project Tesla, so yay for that. And that's going to give me a time. I'll give you a time and date stamp. It's 23 hours and 32 minutes into the day of Friday, June 27th, 2014, and that's right. Project Tesla is now officially on the books, is now officially open, the notes have begun, and let's see where this takes us now. So, as I said, Project Tesla is a go, it's now operational. Alright, I'll talk to you later. This was sort of a nice announcement, and I'll come back, and I still have a couple vlogs to do, and other odds and ends. Anyways, I'll see you later. Alright, I'm going to do a very quick end of the day vlog. Well, somewhat end of the day, because it's been a very, very long day. I really haven't been properly to sleep since Saturday. So, let me give you a time and date stamp. It is 5 hours and 8 minutes into Monday, June 30th, 2014. Yeah. I've realigned my cellular Galvan View. The two top working devices are here in front of me. I have you now on the one on the left, and I have Twitcasting on the right. So I have both platforms I'm going to try doing a daily broadcast on. Let's see how this goes. It's sort of a shot in the dark. It's experimentation, but experimentation doesn't have to be bad. For me, it's whether it succeeds or it fails, you learn something from it, and we'll see where it goes from there. Anyways, tomorrow starts new, a new week. And that means because we began working on Project Tesla on Friday, it means tomorrow when I get up that I'm going to be doing a lot more serious work on Project Tesla. In other words, we're going to start getting more into the meat of things. A lot of the mathematics won't come up for another year, but that's okay. It's going to take a while to really sort of get the handle on things. Alright, I'll talk to you later on. Alright, take it easy. Well, it's time for a beginning segment of the BTS blog. Actually, the beginning of another day. Not a beginning segment, but beginning day. There used to be a beginning segment. when I was doing the vlogs in proper order, and posting the vlogs every day, then there'd be a beginning segment, a middle segment, and an ending segment. But that's not what's happening anymore. Blogging every day, but I'm not uploading every single day. I think that's just too much for some people, so rather than vlogging every day, there's in addition to other show developments, we do, how should I put this, I need to rephrase this. I vlog every day, but I don't upload every day. It's going to be, the vlogs are going up just about twice a week. And, I should say the BTS vlogs, behind the scenes vlogs, are going up every other day, twice a week. Then there's instant vlogs, those are coming along more, the notes are getting more and more organized. And there is content now sort of waiting to go out, so. And you can also see me live now on YouNow and, Twitcasting. They're going to be in the links. I'm updating my links so that you can sort of find me wherever I am. And take a look at that too. So we're going to try out some new things because we are working now towards bringing it on schedule so that we can go live in October. The goal is to have Physics TV go live. We'll see how that ends up working out. I still have a fair bit of work to do, but you know, that's the way things go sometimes. Anyways, I will see you around more later on for at 11 o'clock. That's when the show's live at the Research Desk starts. I start the first half. The first hour is on YouNow, and then the second hour is on Twitcasting. So, if you want to hang out for 2 hours, that's where I'll be. You can follow and check for this on Twitter. Twitter is a feed that's most showing this up. It is actually showing up on Instagram and Facebook, my Instagram and Facebook feeds as well, but the one that's the best, I think, is Twitter in terms of finding me on like YouNow and Twitcast. I think that's the best way of sort of seeing this. Anyways, I think that's going to be it for now. I will talk to you guys later. And yeah, bye.
Be prepared to have what you know challenged by Cyborg Alpha TV Network.
All right, let's do this again. Let's see. It's Wednesday, July 2nd, 2014. It's just about 17 hours into the day. It's about 7 o'clock. So, 19 hours into the day. Because, 7 plus 12 is 19, so it'll be 19 hours into the day of Wednesday, July 2nd, 2014. I'm off going shopping. I don't know how much I'm going to be able to vlog this because it's starting to rain out. It's not that bad, but still, you never know. So, I've been trying out those two new live options now, YouNow and Twitcasting. This is kind of an experiment to see how things go to do live broadcasting. So basically right now, I'm testing out Physics TV Live. So that's kind of a good thing because it means we're beginning our testing earlier than I expected to. So. But it's bizarre, the more popular platform, YouNow, doesn't seem to be as functional as the less popular platform, Twitcasting. And I end up getting better results in terms of the number of viewers on Twitcasting than I do on YouNow. So, you know, these are things you gotta sort of figure out and try out and see how things go. Anyways, I don't really have much anything else to say right now. So I'm gonna leave it here. And if I do think of anything more to say as I'm walking, I'll get you guys out and talk to you again. Alrighty. Take it easy. Oh, you fell down again. Let's see if I can get you standing up straight here. Here we go. Stand up straight again. You keep falling down on me. I don't know why you keep falling down. But anyways, it's been an interesting day. I went food shopping. I ended up getting more stuff for the kitchen diner. The goal is, as I find equipment that's on sale for cheap, to bring in new menu items that will allow me to reduce the overall food cost. And that's what I did today. So, and I estimate that within 2 weeks, with the food savings, I'll pay for what the blender I bought. I bought a blender, pretty good blender. It's really hot out here. My air conditioning is somewhat working. And so what I decided to do is, one of the meals I'm going to be having for one of the meals is going to be a shake. And it's simply because, not because I'm on a diet or anything like that, it's just that during the summer heat, you don't need the amount of nutrients that you would have if you're having meat and sandwiches all the time. Sandwiches add a lot of carbohydrate in there, particularly because of the bread. So yeah, the sandwich is cold, but the bread adds an enormous amount of carbohydrates to your system. And that's not necessarily so good, because that produces heat. And if you're already in a hot environment and your body's producing more heat because of the carbohydrates, well, you're going to only be hotter. So the solution to that is increase in hydration. That means more water. And as I said, if I have a shake for one meal, that's more than enough calories. And of course, there's the nutrients from the milk, the fresh fruit. In my shakes, I don't. My shakes are a combination of a smoothie and a shake. It's not necessarily all ice cream. As a matter of fact, it's just there's almost no ice cream in there at all. Just some milk, chocolate syrup, fruit, and that forms the shake. So there's more than enough nutrients in there to carry me through for 4 or 5 hours at minimum anyway. So it's good enough to skip a full size meal. What else is there? The live broadcasts are going well. I was pleasantly surprised. I did a hangout today, a live hangout for my YouTube channel. And I thought that the video wasn't going to be that good in terms of it's going to be too small for 720p for like I have my 1080p screen here, my OpenIP TV, and I want to sort of create my channel so that people can view it on their TVs. And I was concerned that it wouldn't scale up properly, but YouTube does a good job at scaling these things up, and it did fit the screen properly. It was very well formed, so I was happy with what I saw. So basically, what you'll be seeing actually before this video gets up, you'll be seeing more live broadcasts. Now, I think it's going to be about 3 hours worth of live broadcasts from 10 o'clock at night till about 1 o'clock in the morning. That's what the schedule is right now. Anyways, so. Anyways, I will talk to you in a bit. It's time to go, because I think I'm going to call it a day, because the internet is down for some maintenance, and I don't know when it's going to be back up again, so I think that's going to be about it for today. Alright, night. Oh, almost forgot. Time and date stamp, right? It is 4 hours. And 11 minutes into the day of Thursday, June 3rd, July 3rd, 2014. Tomorrow is July 4th. That's American Independence Day. July 1st just passed, so happy Canada Day to people who are Canadian. All right, they. Oh, you fell down again. Let's see if we can get you standing up straight here. Here we go. Stand up straight again. You keep falling down on me. I don't know why you keep falling down. But anyways, it's been an interesting day. I went food shopping. I ended up getting more stuff for the kitchen diner. The goal is, as I find equipment that's on sale for cheap, to bring in new menu items that will allow me to reduce the overall food cost. And that's what I did today. So, and I estimate that within 2 weeks, with the food savings, I'll pay for what the blender I bought. I bought a blender, pretty good blender. It's really hot out here. My air conditioning is somewhat working. And so what I decided to do is, one of the meals I'm going to be having for one of the meals is going to be a shake. And it's simply because, not because I'm on a diet or anything like that, it's just that during the summer heat, you don't need the amount of nutrients that you would have if you're having meat and sandwiches all the time. Sandwiches add a lot of carbohydrate in there, particularly because of the bread. So yeah, the sandwich is cold, but the bread adds an enormous amount of carbohydrates to your system. And that's not necessarily so good, because that produces heat, and if you're already in a hot environment and your body's producing more heat because of the carbohydrates, well, you're going to only be hotter. So the solution to that is increase in hydration. That means more water. And as I said, if I have a shake for one meal, that's more than enough calories. And of course, there's the nutrients from the milk, the fresh fruit. In my shakes, I don't. My shakes are a combination of a smoothie and a shake. It's not necessarily all ice cream. As a matter of fact, it's just there's almost no ice cream in there at all. Just some milk, chocolate syrup, fruit, and that forms the shake. So there's more than enough nutrients in there to carry me through for 4 or 5 hours at minimum anyway. So it's good enough to skip a full size meal. What else is there? The live broadcasts are going well. I was pleasantly surprised. I did a hangout today, a live hangout for my YouTube channel. And I thought that the video wasn't going to be that good in terms of it's going to be too small for 720p for like I have my 1080p screen here, my open IPTV, and I want to sort of create my channel so that people can view it on their TVs. And I was concerned that, you know, it wouldn't scale up properly, but you know, YouTube does a good job at scaling these things up, and it did fit the screen properly. It was very well formed, so I was happy with what I saw. So, basically, what you'll be seeing, actually, before this video gets up, you'll be seeing more live broadcasts. Now, I think it's going to be about 3 hours worth of live broadcasts from 10 o'clock at night till about 1 o'clock in the morning. That's what the schedule is right now. Anyway, so... anyways, I will talk to you in a bit. It's time to go, because I think I'm going to call it a day, because the internet is down for some maintenance, and I don't know when it's going to be back up again, so I think that's going to be about it for today. All right, night. Oh, almost forgot. Time and date stamp, right? It is 4 hours. and 11 minutes into the day of Thursday, June 3rd, July 3rd, 2014. Tomorrow is July 4th, that's American Independence Day. July 1st just passed, so happy Canada Day to people who are Canadian. Alright, night.
Good morning, everybody. It's time for another segment of the BTS vlog. And as I said before, it's not necessarily morning, it's just I'm getting up now. I've changed up my schedule so that I'm basically vlogging right after I get out of bed. This is the beginning of my day. This is actually the beginning of the day. I haven't gone around done anything yet. The sleep is still in my eyes, and so, well, here we are. Let me give you a time and date stamp. It is 19 hours and 49 minutes into the day of Friday, July 4th, 2014. Happy Independence Day to those who are American. I am originally from Boston, so yay for me too. I know a lot of my family are probably celebrating the 4th. are celebrating the 4th of July. Excuse me. I've had 3 successful nights of live. We're going to go into the 4th night of successful, hopefully successful, live broadcast. We're going to be doing government and conspiracy again today. I've got some new, even when you're sleeping, you're kind of thinking about what's going on, trying to figure out what to do next. And I think a lot of that stuff is off the top of my head, so it does take a bit of effort. To do this, and I'm not the type of person, I can't read off a script. I'm not a script person, so I do have to actually know my stuff. I have to know what I'm talking about. I can't simply read it, and this is kind of the way things go. All this is practice. This is practice to speak in front of the camera, to correct my mistakes, to correct my posture, to correct my manner. Excuse me. And if this channel is about seeing something real, removing the fakeness, the phoniness, and the contrived, then you're going to see the human foibles, you're going to see the yawns, you're going to see the hiccups, you're going to see a human being in front of you having a discussion. And that's, for me, that's kind of the way, as I said, people are now my books. This is where you get history from. If people are the history. And this is what I was talking about last night, how people are history. And that you can get a large chunk of history that's missing from the textbooks. From people, particularly from older people, You sit around and listen to their stories. And, if you learn more about them, look at their photography. Look at their pictures, find out more about them. You'll find that these people had interesting lives and that they lived in periods of time that we now call history. And you can learn more about the history from a personal aspect than from the standard boring textbook. Textbooks are rather boring. They draw a large chunk of the information. is either missing or incorrect. In many cases, both is both missing and incorrect. So we're gonna head to there. It's about 8 o'clock now. We start at 10 o'clock. I got 2 hours before I get to the live show, so I have to move back to the front room, the library. We're doing it from the library now, so. Anyways, I'll see you in 2 hours at the library. And of course, you're not going to be seeing this as it occurs in sequence. You'll be seeing this afterward because these vlogs always go up after the after a couple of days. I'm kind of behind, as you may well know. Anyways, I will be there within about 2 hours. Anyways, see you then. All right, bye-bye. Thank you.
I am the professor. And professor of what? Professor of physics.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light?
Free speech rules here at Democratic Earth.